Hi everyone and welcome to NameHero.com. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about our PHP selector and as well as the PHP options that we have inside of cPanel. So what we see with a lot of our web hosting customers that come in is many of them want to run different versions of PHP. They need to set different memory limits. They need to set different upload limits. So the simplest way to do this is by offering it inside of cPanel. I know some of the other big brand web hosts, such as HostGator and Bluehost, they create a PHP any file inside of the public HTML directory, and they specify these limits in there. Sometimes they'll also recommend that these limits are set inside the WordPress configuration file, so wp-config.php. The problem I see with that, it just really complicates things, especially for beginners. Those that really don't have any technical knowledge, they just find that confusing. They feel like it's just a really big pain in the butt to get anything done. So an example of one of these errors looks like this. Let me drag it on here. So fatal error, allowed memory size of whatever it is, exhausted in whatever file that it is. So we see this a lot in our ticket desk. Excuse me. So I wanted to do a video where I show you how to fix this error, because it certainly should not be an error that you get, or it should be an easy one to fix. So we see also a lot, and this memory error especially comes up when you're uploading a theme, and the theme uses a lot of memory to actually compile in the browser. So if PHP doesn't have enough memory allocated to it, then of course you're going to get this error most likely on a white page, and it's very frustrating. So I'm going to show you how to fix that error, as well as how to take full control over your PHP right inside a cPanel. So on your screen is our basic web hosting packages, and you can see these are all new for 2018. We actually specify the amount of RAM and CPU cores you can use. Now this is important, because the more memory you allocate to PHP, the less it starts chipping away at your RAM. So of course, if you have a really popular site and it takes a lot of memory to load each page of your site, you're going to want a bigger package. So the more hits you get, the bigger package you get. So that's just very important to keep in mind. So to access this, you want to log into your account. So I'm now logged into my demonstration account. Now I've got a couple different packages here, but I mainly just want to go into cPanel. So I'm going to go to my Reseller Hosting US account, and I'm going to log into cPanel. It's by far the easiest to get to cPanel through our client interface, because you can single sign on. You don't have to worry about re-logging in again. So I'm going to click log into cPanel from here, and you can see I am now inside of cPanel. So to get to the PHP selector, I just want to type in PHP, and you're going to see under software, you're going to see select PHP version. So when I click on this, you're going to see my current version is set at 5.6. Now, if you're running just WordPress on your website and all your scripts are updated and themes and plugins, which they should be, I highly recommend going to at least 7.0 PHP. If you're using a script that needs the IonCube loader, sometimes 7.1 and 7.2 doesn't function correctly yet, because everyone's still trying to update their software to include the latest version of IonCube. But I really recommend jumping from 5.6 to 7.0 because of the speed benefits. So I'm going to select 7.0, and once I select it here, I need to click Set as Current, because I need this to say Current PHP version 7.0 like this. And that's how I know it's set. So as soon as I do that, you're going to see I've got all these PHP extensions on my screen. Now, a bunch of these are already checked by default, such as the IonCube loader. So check with your WordPress theme or the scripts you're running, and most of the time, they will all tell you what extensions you need. By default, the ones are selected. If you need to add extra ones, of course you can. So most of the time, you don't have to touch these, but if you're using a specific script or a specific plugin that needs something, an extension, then you can select it here and then click Save. So I'm just going to leave these default. I want to go to Switch to PHP Options, because this is going to be the area where we fix errors that look like this. So we're going to fix those in PHP Options. So I'm going to click Switch to PHP Options. And now I get all this information. Now this is what you would typically set up in your PHP any file or your WP config file if you're coming over from one of the big brand hosts, such as HostGator and Bluehost. You don't have to do those complicated files anymore. Everything is taken care of right here inside a cPanel, and it's just point and click. So most of the time, this is the culprit for that error, is the memory limit. So again, the error looks like this, and the solution is increasing your memory limit right here. So you can see by default, 7.0's PHP is set at 128. Now most of the time, that's high enough to fix anything. But if you're still getting that error, you can go up to 256 megabytes, click apply. Now, I really don't recommend going any higher than that because you're really going to start chipping away at that RAM that's allocated for your website. And so you don't want to use up all that unless you're on a very powerful package. So, you know, 256 megabytes, you shouldn't go over that. I know most of the themes and plugins out there do not require anything higher than that. So that's a big one here. Another one that we see is the post max size. We see people getting errors when they're trying to upload images in WordPress. So a lot of times 8 megabytes is too small. So you want to go to 64 megabytes, apply. And then finally, the upload limit is another one. And I can't see it right now, so we're just going to type in upload max file size. It's right at the bottom. So I like to increase that as well to 64 megabytes. Apply. Now, once I make all my changes, you're going to see they're in orange, and that's because they've not been applied yet, that you've made the changes, but you have to apply it, and you apply it by clicking save. So setting saved, and now you have made the changes. So if I refresh this page here, you're going to see these are in green. This lets you know that they've been customized and they are active. That's why they're in green instead of orange. So, of course, if you have other changes you need to make, which these are really, a lot of themes require these to be increased as well, which is why we have these in here. But any of these other options can be changed. And to change them, you just simply click on them and, you know, you enter what values, click apply, then down here and save. So you can pretty much change anything in PHP right inside of here. So that's why it's, you know, it's important to become familiar with this screen in the PHP selector at NameHero. Because remember, we don't just limit you to one version of PHP. You have all these versions. I mean, I really don't recommend running 4.4 because that's really old. But if you need to test a script, say, hey, you know, I need to test this on a 4.4 because maybe some of my customers are going to need 4.4 for some dev or something. You know, you can test on there. But I always recommend going to 7.0 at least. Now, if I go over here to my example blog, I'm just going to click visit site. You'll notice how fast this page is. And that's because I've got the Lightspeed cache, I've got PHP 7.0, and really it just freaking flies. I mean, it's really amazing about how fast this is, and especially for shared hosting, for it to be this fast. Now, if you want to enable Lightspeed cache, I've got some tutorials on the YouTube channel here at NameHero, or on the NameHero blog, namehero.com/startup, or namehero.com/blog, either one you prefer, on how to install that and get that going, because that's definitely going to make a difference in how fast your page loads. But definitely selecting PHP 7.0, that's the first step to really getting optimized, and then changing these values to meet whatever theme or plugin that you may have. Now, of course, if you have a problem, you can always submit a ticket to our support team and they can change these values for you. But I'm the type of person that when I have an issue, I like to just fix it right away. And so this is the solution to fixing errors like this, these fatal errors, is changing them like this. You know, one thing I kind of find it a little bit humorous is in our support desk, some people will get really mad when they get this error. They'll say, hey, you know, I don't have enough, you didn't give me enough memory, and I need more memory for my WordPress theme. My previous host never had this. Well, the thing is, we do give you memory, but we set these kind of low as default, and that's because some people, they don't need so much memory, so why chip away at your RAM when you don't have to? That's why we set them default to a low setting, and then if you need it, you by all means go in and set it. So at first, we have like our optimized settings that are just set as default. Then you can tweak it to your sites. And so that's the funny thing about operating a shared hosting infrastructure, not really the funny, the more challenging thing, is when you're doing a shared hosting infrastructure, not all settings work for everyone. So by adding the PHP selector inside of cPanel, each customer inside NameHero can be specific to their own needs. That way it's not one setting for all rules the roost. Every site can set their own specific settings to make things work and function as they need. Once again, this is all found right inside of cPanel. You just click, just type in PHP, select PHP version, and you will be brought to these screens. Now, also, if you go to PHP and click PHP here, I'm sorry, it's not right here. PHP, it's not right in here, I'm sorry. But just right and select PHP version is where you're going to see all of these options and where you can get to all this stuff. You know, one suggestion that I have for developers out there is just by calling it select PHP version, some people may get that confused. So one suggestion I have is that we probably should rename that to something different, because the PHP selector is so much more, because it's got these options and it's got these extensions. But this is really a lifesaver and really a time saver for a lot of people. You can get rid of the PHP any file. So if you're coming over from HostGator and you have a PHP any file, delete it. You don't need it anymore. If you have customizations in your WP config, delete them. You don't need them anymore. Everything is done right inside of here, and everything can be added and set up. This way, you know where everything is, and you can kind of take things from there. If you have any questions, feel free to comment on this video. I'm going to put it on the blog too, so comment on there as well. This will solve the dreaded memory exhausted error, which can be very frustrating. So this will solve all those issues for you all. Again, let me know if you have any questions, but thanks so much for watching. Thanks for using NameHero.com.